Hello and welcome, Grafana Champion is here. My name is Daria Volkova and this channel helps utilize Grafana to its full potential. Today's video is another use case review video. I will show you how to configure the data manipulation plugin to synchronize it with the dashboard variables. So it will look like this. On the dashboard, I have dashboard variables and the data manipulation plugin. When I change the filters on top, the data manipulation elements values change accordingly and vice versa. Please note, it is not a comprehensive plugin overview video. If you need to learn the basics of the data manipulation plugin or dashboard variables, please refer to the links below in the description box. Are you ready for this use case review? Let's go! The idea for this video comes from one of our GitHub sponsors. Thank you for the inspiration. To simplify the use case, I will rephrase the question as follows. There is a function in Grafana dashboard. It has two things, hierarchical filters, which are dashboard variables, and any dashboard analytical graph. It rebuilds following the selected filters on top. However, this graph here is only for context. It doesn't play any role in the solution. I will remove it. By hierarchical dashboard variables, I mean a structure like this. Here I have three different facilities with two rooms in each and two benches in every room. To avoid any ambiguities, I will use prefixes for every data element in the hierarchy, so my structure looks like this. With that dashboard, the question is how to set up the data manipulation plugin so it looks very similar to the dashboard variable filters, meaning with three hierarchical dropdowns, and it is synchronized with the dashboard variables. I start by creating dashboard variables. Under the Variables menu, I click Add Variable, the first variable with the name Facility. It has three constant values, so type Custom, then provide the custom options, Facility 1, Facility 2, and Facility 3, separated by comma. The second variable has the name room, type query, since I need to ensure it depends on the first variable. Data source static. We often use the static data source for our demos, but obviously you are going to use your data source with your actual values. I will add two fields, a value with string type and a label with the same string type. Values. Here I reference the first variable by the dollar sign and then the first variable name facility, room 1. For simplicity, set a label to the identical value. I need a second row of values for the second room. Run query button. Two rooms are displayed for the selected facility 1. The third variable has the name bench. Again, query type, data source static, same fields, value and label. The values are a reference to the second variable and have bench 1 and bench 2 for every selected room. Here is what my dashboard looks like at this point. Three dropdowns are on top. The second depends on the value selected in the first dropdown, and the third depends on the chosen value in the second dropdown. Now let's see how to add the synchronized data manipulation panel. Add visualization, select data manipulation from the list. In the new element area, specify ID, facility, label, facility name, type, select with custom options, add element button. Get back to the facility properties and extend the label length to 12. Repeat for the room and then repeat for the bench. Save and apply. On the dashboard, the data manipulation has these three empty dropdowns. To populate them with values, I go back to Edit Mode and configure the data source. Select Static. Again, I use it for the demo purposes. Please select what works for you here. Name Facility Options. My goal is to replicate the values of the dashboard variables, so I add the same fields, Value and Label. For the values, I add three rows, Facility 1, Facility 2, and Facility 3. Add another query. Call it Room Options. Same fields, Value and Label. Values, first row reference to the facility variable and room 1. The second reference is the facility variable and room 2. Third query, Bench Options, has similar steps. fields, value, and label. Values, dashboard variable room, and bench one. And then the second row, dashboard variable room, and bench two. Let's switch to the table view. Here I have three data frames, one per query I just created. Facility query has three facilities, then all rooms for the specified facility and all benches for the specified room. In the next step, I need to map these data frames to the data manipulation elements. I do it in the element detail on the left. Option source set to query and then specify value field and label field. The same goes for the room element. Options source set to query, specify value field and label field. The same repeats for the bench element. Query, value field, label field. Everything is ready to work on the synchronization. We need synchronization to happen on three actions. The first action is a page load, and the second is when dashboard variables change on top. To solve this, I do two things. Create another query. I call it initial values. Add three fields, facility, room, and bench. Values refer to the facility variable, the room variable, and the bench variable. In the initial request section, the initial action is set to query. With that, every element has a new parameter, query field. I set it to facility for facility, room for the room, and bench for the bench element. With that, whenever the dashboard is loaded, the data manipulation displays the same values as in the dashboard variables. Also, whenever I change the dashboard variables on top, the data manipulation form elements follow. The last action is when a user changes a value in the data manipulation panel. If I change the facility here, then dashboard variables do not follow yet. The synchronization can be done in the new section, form elements, option element value changed. Here I insert the following code. It executes after any changes in the data manipulation form elements. Here is where I will ensure that the dashboard variables are updated accordingly. Save, let's check the dashboard. Choose different values in the data manipulation, and the dashboard variables follow. Almost done. The final touch is to make the submit button smarter. When a dashboard is just loaded, I want the submit button to be disabled. I want it to be enabled only when a user changes something on the form. For that, in the update request, I set enable update to manual. Then modify the code by adding one row which enables the submit button. This code runs after any changes on the data manipulation form occur. On the dashboard, by default, the submit button is disabled, but after some modifications, it became blue, meaning active. Optionally, I can add other elements to send more data into my database. How to make them work? Please refer to other videos on this channel, links below. That is all for configuration. Quick and easy setup. I hope you enjoyed watching me create this dashboard. Feel free to ask questions. If you have any exciting use case, we will gladly review them and publish them on our blog, volkoflabs.io/blog, or we could even devote a whole video to your use case. That is all for now. Thank you for watching and see you next time.